Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Lobotomy Corporation Season 3. We are ready to go here for day number 4 on the channel. Thank you, everybody, for the support on the Lobotomy Corporation series. As a quick reminder, this is part of a backlog series of episodes that I've been recording because I've got some personal stuff I need to take care of for this week. So that means that I will not be having any quick turnarounds for any questions or anything regarding the comment section. All I ask, again, as a quick reminder, to please keep spoilers out of the comment section and keep it fun and interesting for everybody, new and old fans alike. As you see here, we have added two new employees. We've got Kurt Hugo Schneider here. Welcome, Kurt. Good to see you. You look very familiar. Not that we haven't seen you yesterday, but, you know, good to see you. And we also have Lili, our artist, very talented artist. Again, her contact information can be found down below on her Twitter. She does very awesome art, and she's also the artist who's helped me quite a bit with some Lobotomy Corporation thumbnails, including the art for Angela on this series here for this season. So thank you, Lili. Make sure you go give her a follow and tell her a lot of love, or show her a lot of love from the Mosh Pit. Here we go, day 4. Let's see what this new abnormality is. Also, by the way, I have kitted out people with extra armor really quickly here. Lili and Sinvicta both now wearing the horn armor, along with Sinvicta still has penitents for his weapon, because obviously we want some white damage. I'll talk about that I'll talk about it right now. Essentially, if someone loses their sanity or loses their mind, you can hit them with employees that deal white damage to restore their sanity instead of them going just off the deep end. Lili now has the horn, or also the beauty weapon, if you want to call it that. So she is dealing red damage along with having the Teth level armor as well. Same thing goes for Sinvicta, except for the white armor. Husky now is brandishing the beak weapon, the pistol that we got from the Punching Bird, because obviously he's got the +2 attack speed as well, or the increased attack speed from his does he have that attack speed? No, it's HP and SP. Oh, whatever. Anyway, yeah, so he's got that. And then Kurt, of course, sticking with the penitence, because we need more people to have white damage, but he is rocking the horn armor. So let us begin here. Clip off meltdown containment unit work 8. Oof. Gotta deal 8. We have to deal with 8 clip off meltdowns. So this is a music box. So essentially what this is a tool abnormality. What this is they are items that you can actually use or channel, and they will do a variety of things. So we're gonna have Lili go in here first. Beauty, we'll go ahead and have Sinvicta go just because we can handle it. Punching Bird, we know that Husky can handle that as well, and Kurt can get the easy low ball here and work with one bro. Now, I don't remember what this ballerina tool does totally, but one thing that you have to be careful about tool abnormalities, because they can instagib you without warning. Also, remember, we have more abnormalities this time, so we need to be careful about Punishing Bird's clip-off counter. Okay, we're going to stop Lili using that. So how long was that? That was good for music box with a dancing ballerina. Sometimes you listen to Teresa's music will recover SP. That's good. That's right. This thing's name is Teresa. But I think that something happens if you listen too long. Again, I don't want to try to meta game this too much, but I do want to be careful. Cumulative time, 14 seconds. We'll have Lili go back in there. We need someone to do insight work on Beauty. Let's have Sinvicta do it again. Punching Bird will go with Husky, and then one bro, Kurt. We have a cliff off meltdown level 1 here. It's going to be on the music box for Teresa. All right, so that was we're still not at observation level 1 here. Let's make some sacrifices to collect half our energy already. At 36 seconds, so it looks like the next observation level is going to be at 1 minute. But let's see what happens if we put Lili in there with 1 minute. Sorry, Lili. I'm pretty sure this is a safe abnormality, a safe tool to work with, though. I think. I'm willing to take the risk to put you in harm's way. Kurt, we'll keep on working here. So as soon as we see this go to level 2, we know that it's been a minute. Let's take Lili out there. It's going to be another meltdown on Teresa. So let's pause this for a second and see what's the observation level 2. When the spring is wound, a sad melody begins to play. No one knows when or who made it, but it doesn't seem new, judging from the light skips of music. Listening to the music box for 20 to 30 seconds, the subject's SP will fall rapidly, causing them to panic. But we don't want to listen to it for more than 20 seconds. Lili looks, she looks like she's unharmed, so we're just going to keep nickel and diming this for now. A4 work complete, but obviously we're not going to stop there because we have a long way to go. We want to make sure we stop Lily around 20 seconds or so. She didn't start taking damage there, so we're just going to put her back in. Inside tier, we'll go with Ghost Invicta. We'll go with the safe plays for now. Punching Bird's now at 3. We need to be careful about that. Go with more insight here for Husky. Husky doing a good job working on punishing the stupid bird. Three boxes left, and we'll be maxed out on punishing bird here. We'll have Kurt go over here this time because we need to share the love a little bit. We need Lily to have some good gains here. All right, so punishing bird and beauty are going to be the next two on the list. Vic is ready to go, so we'll just go ahead and put him in there. That's going to count for the next second. That's going to count for the third and the fourth meltdown containment unit work jobs here. Up Husky, maxed out on Punishing Bird now, so that's good. He's got some pretty good gear. Lily getting some good work there on one bro. Almost forgot about Kurt. Luckily I didn't, so Husky there. And already, as you can tell, it is much more hectic and frantic, and it's very easy to lose track of who's been where. You need to make sure you don't forget about people. Let's go for insight work. I'm going to pause here. I'm going to stop Teresa. Okay. So let's see, level 3 now. There's a sentence carved crudely on it. Remember the melody? Remember this melody? The professor played the song when the students were sleepy. Happy birthday. And then we need to go all the way 3 minutes now for the final amount. So we have 30 seconds left, so we do not want this to hit 4, because then we'll know we're at 30% and we are 30 seconds, and that Kurt will indeed be going crazy. So we need to keep an eye on him. We also need to keep an eye on the clip off counter for Punishing Bird. Stop that, and we have 7 seconds. So we were very close for him going over, but luckily it didn't happen. Lili, keep that there. And 4, there we go. Listening to the music box makes anyone feel like everything's going to be okay and their fatigue is lifted, but excessive listening will make the subject lose grip on reality, driving them mad. So essentially this is just a mental healing station that we have here. That's gonna be very good for us later on. Kurt, why don't you just go work on that real quick? And again, as you see here with the tool abnormalities, they're very, very easy to work through meltdowns and stuff with. So I wonder if you think Lili could handle Punching Bird? Probably not. I mean, she is going to be taking 8% less damage. Physical damage? I forgot about Kurt. So we need Sinvicta to hit Kurt for now. So this is a problem because and now Punishing Bird has also escaped. No problem. Not a problem. It's not a problem. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have Husky. We do not want Husky fighting Kurt. The reason why we don't want that is essentially because, well, we don't want Husky to accidentally kill Kurt. That can't happen. We need somebody with white damage to go hit Kurt. Looks like Kurt's moving back up there. Now, panicking employees will also cause other employees to panic, so we need to be careful about that. And combined with the fact that Punishing Bird's already out of there, we need to be very, very careful of everyone's SP, especially our newer employees. So Lili, I'm going to have her move down here. We need Sinvicta to get Kurt back here. Now, if employees are panicking... If employees are panicking enough, they will also break. And we don't want that to happen. So we need Lili to get out of here. There's Kurt. I'm going to go suppress Kurt. Again, the reason why we need Sinvicta to do this is because he deals white damage, and if we can successfully damage Kurt enough, insanity damage, we can get him back. Now, if the employees are panicking at the end of the day, they're actually considered dead, so we don't want that. Lily's getting hit by Punishing Bird. We're going to micro her back over here. There's a fair bit of micromanagement going on. Let's monitor everyone's SP. Victor's doing okay. Kurt's got a long way to go. Lily is almost actually completely panicked too, so we need to be careful that this doesn't snowball out of control. Husky, where are you going? Okay, did I get hit there on Kurt? No. Husky, get back up here. Now, the problem with One Bros... Okay, new plan. Let's get a perfect here on One Bro. Let's get a perfect here on One Bro so we can heal everyone's SP. Victa's still okay. I don't know if One Bro's SP will actually work on a panicking employee already, but we can try it with Husky. I really don't want to lose Kurt for a second time and have to remake him, because that's a lot of wasted lobotomy points. Yeah, One Bro's weapon just swings far too slow for me to actually get a hit on him. So we need someone to get a perfect on One Bro, and of course Husky failed, because thanks, Husky. His weapon's so slow. No, Husky. Husky, we need you to come back and you don't understand, Husky. Husky, I need you to get a perfect on One Bro. Meltdown's incoming. Kurt's still at 4. Lili is okay. Let's have Lili go in here. I promise I will not forget about Lili. I promise. I will not forget about Lili. We need to work on Beauty, because obviously we're going to be melting down again. So let's just get that one done real quick, since I cannot suppress Kurt because he won't stop moving. I promise I will not forget about Lili. I really wish Husky would get a perfect on One Bro. I don't know if us getting a perfect on One Bro will restore Kurt. Will restore Kurt. That's something that I want to try, but Husky is failing miserably. So instead I'm going to have Sinvicta do it, because Husky cannot be trusted. Insight, we could... I don't want to risk someone getting killed right now. I'm going to have Husky work on Instinct for Beauty, because it at least gives him an HP boost. And hopefully Sinvic can get a perfect here and get Kurt back. Nope. It's pretty easy to get a perfect on One Bro. I don't know why we're not doing it. This also sort of highlights the importance of having a ranged white weapon. We are suppressing Berserk and Clear, by the way. So Husky was able to do that. How much damage did Husky take from that? Not a lot. Good job, Husky. We'll have him get a little bit more. All right, One Bro, look. I got to be honest with you, One Bro. We really need you to let us get a perfect here. Lili, go use that. One Bro, we have failed. Well, if we have to let Kurt die, I guess that's just in the cards here. Come on, One Bro. Come on, man. You've always been a bro, One Bro. I'm going to have Husky just spam Fortitude work right now, because we want him to get an HP buff. It's Invicta looking for the perfect. Can we get it? We got it! Did not restore SP on Kurt. Actually, it did. It restored a little bit, but he's still panicking. Restored 4. So we'd have to do that three more times in order for him to actually become unpanicked. So, Sinvicta, if we can get 3 more perfects, or if we can actually land an attack on Kurt, that'd be great. And we've already failed it. Lobotomy Corporation is at its finest when it's its most hectic. Here again, I'm gonna keep Husky getting some instinct work here. Some fortitude buffs. We can't really trust. Not that we don't trust Lili, of course, but we can't really trust her to get a perfect on One Bro. And it's also a little bit too scary for us to work with Punishing Bird. Although Punishing Bird's clip off counter is going to keep on going down the more times that we actually go into these different abnormality cameos. We got another perfect there. So Kurt is slowly getting back, and actually one more looks like it may do it. Don't worry. Oh, Sinvicta got the ego gift. Yes, I got the ego gift from One Bro. Thank you, One Bro. All right, Punishing Bird needs to be dealt with. Husky, go take care of Punishing Bird. Teresa can be handled by Lily, and then we're going to also have Lily go deal with Beauty. She should be able to handle Beauty. She should. Actually, no, Beauty's not melting down. Never mind. I take that back. Did not get a perfect there on one bro. I got the ego gift from one bro, and I appreciate that, one bro. The Crown of Thorns, it does, it's called Penitence. It gives you plus 2 SP, work success rate, plus 10% against the original abnormality, which means that we have a good chance of getting a perfect. There we go. That was our next perfect. Is Kurt free? Kurt's not free. Needs one more insanity point. Yeah, so I needed three more totals. So Sinvicta should be able to get this one here. And let's get a little bit more fortitude, but actually Husky needs to get healed first. And Husky's fortitude took a dip, man. There we go. What was that, Sinvicta? Did we do the wrong thing, or did we just get bad RNG on that? Let's try this again here, buddy. We have a 10%. Nah, he failed it. We have a 10% chance. Look, Kurt, we're doing this for you, buddy. Old buddy, old pal. I wish Lily was strong enough to get to take Beauty. She should be able to take. She should be able to handle Beauty, I would think. But I don't want to risk losing someone else. Let's just get Kurt back and get on out of here. Okay. All right, well, Husky's going to have to take care of that, and then Lily's going to have to take care of Beauty and the Beast. If Sinvicta can get a perfect here, then Kurt can go handle Beauty and the Beast. But, of course, we failed the perfect. So, actually, Sinvicta, we're going to have him go handle Beauty. Actually, I'm going to go for Instinct because I want to get a 4-2 buff as well. One bro can be handled by Lily. Who knows? Maybe Lily will have the perfect and save Kurt. It's possible. Oh, Kurt's back. We got Kurt back. Look at that. So Kurt's sanity was indeed restored. Maybe he might have stayed in the regenerator enough for it to tick over while he was in there. Welcome back, Kurt. Good to have you. Sinvicta absolutely got destroyed on Beauty and the Beast, but that's okay. Lily barely made it there in time. Good job, Lily. Let's see if she can get the perfect to end it off. So not a bad day, all things considered. We almost lost Kurt, but again, it sort of highlights the how crazy stuff can get in Lobotomy Corporation on a moment's notice. I am happy that we finished the second round of of max outs on Punishing Bird. I shouldn't risk it. I really shouldn't. But you would think with the horn armor, even level one. Of course, it's Kurt that we're doing this with, but you know. I mean, Kurt should be able to handle that, right? He's already taken a lot of sanity damage. He's able to handle it. Good job. Good job, team. Yeah, Punishing Bird's about to get out, so I think that's a good time to stop this one here. A little bit of a shorter episode today, but that's okay. Let's go ahead and end day four. Got an S rank. Everyone survived, and look at the big buffs here. Sinvicta getting plus one to Temperance, plus one to Justice as well. No Fortitude gains, unfortunately. Husky finally got a Fortitude gain. Prudence going to four here as well. Husky's now the strongest mentally, anyway, that we have for employees. Kurt got a little bit of a bonus there, along with Lily. Lily didn't get a whole lot as far as work success and stuff goes, but she did get a lot for Sandy, and I'm happy about that because that is very good. She's actually already at 24, still at Prudence level 1. Good job, Lily. The founder said this to me several times. Each successful experiment makes you a better person. The company became great after repeated failures and difficulties. So will you. Every day in the company is a step forward towards greatness. How was your day? Of course it was fine. Let's spare the pleasantries. Manager, how's your life been? Been okay. Leading a normal life is an achievement of sort. You can always improve the quality of your life. Cheap metaphor, but a tree doesn't just grow anywhere. It requires fertile soil, the right temperature, and water. Most seeds end up on barren soil. For them, rooting and sprouting small leaves are a challenge full of pain. I can't provide you with water or light, but I will do my best to tend to the soil. Thanks, Angela. And here we go.
Ew, let me be honest, Malkuth. You can't suppress ordeals with the employees you have. I'm Yassad. Trust me, I'm from the information team. If you do it by yourself, there'd be too much mental damage to the employees, nerd.
Yassad, we need to think about the morality rate, the mortality rate of employees and possibilities of abnormalities escaping. Malkuth, Angela said one crazy employee will kill 10 others. And there's a fire of the control team. I might make outrageous mistakes in other aspects, but I know this better than anyone else. I know how to treat employees before they go crazy. I have an action guide for it. Honestly, I might be the only one who follows the action guide. Tell me if you need it. I can always share it with you. I'm okay, but that action guide... I don't need weak employees in my department. Weakness makes death. Weakness means death. Being the control team means to be better than everyone else. Please say something, manager. Weren't you watching what happened to the weak employees? Would you guys please say something? Well, thank you so much for visiting me. I was so happy. Let's meet up again next time with the Upper Sapphiris. I will let them know. Mental corruption of the control team employees exceeded the maximum limit. What did the other Sapphiris do in the meantime? The control team failed to handle ordeals. Get more employees and stop the ordeals. I will ask other departments for support. Okay, complete the ordeal of dusk. Day 5, here we go. So we are now being introduced to ordeals here. And ordeals are going to be a new cog in the Lobotomy Corporation wheel. But I'm going to stop it there. Thank you, everybody, for the support. I really do appreciate that. If you're enjoying this video, please consider clicking the like button. And let me know down below if you want to see more Lobotomy Corporation or click the dislike button. Either way, it helps out and supports my channel and the series. Thank you, everybody, for liking, commenting, and subscribing on the Lobotomy Corporation Season 3 series. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!